Hello and welcome to my vlog.
What I used to do was I would scare traffic lights into turning green. I'm sure I'm not the only child that did this. Basically, what you would do is you'd sit in the car and you'd stare up at the lights and it'd be like red, right? And you'd be like, one, two, three, boo! And 9 times out of 10, it didn't actually turn green at that time because that's not how it worked. But when I was a kid, and it did succeed, my parents would be like, good job, you totally scared the traffic light, it didn't want to be red anymore, it was just too afraid of you, and you're tiny. I was like, no. Yeah, I actually believe that. Another thing was that, and this is when I was like really little, it was possible to grow up into your favorite animal. So like, you know how they'd always tell you that you can be whatever you wanted to be? Well, I wanted to be like a tiger. So I honest to God think that I would like be capable of somehow changing my species and become a giant tiger person. Maybe that's how like furries happen. They just like never grow out of that. I don't know, I probably offended somebody. Alright, if it was darker in a specific area than everything else around it, like say you're playing hide and seek, right? And you decide, because you're super clever, you're going to hide in the bathtub and you're going to pull the shower curtain and it's going to be super awesome, right? Nobody's going to check in the bathroom because it's too dark and too scary and there's no lights that go in there. So I would go in there and I'd sit and I'd be in the corner of the bathtub and then I would see, like, right there, you know, where the wall met the actual corner. It would be really, really dark right there. And I, honest to God, would think that it, like, opened into a portal to an alternate dimension where like all of the things that we thought were myths actually existed. So like, you know, when it's, I don't know if it happened to you, but when it's really, really dark and I'm staring into a really dark area, I'll suddenly see colors and like shapes and stuff. And like, I would see unicorns and I would see ghosts and crap. And I was like, oh, it's the fourth dimension. Yeah. So that was a thing. And, and if you get too close to that little spot, then you would actually be pulled in to that other dimension, a la the Twilight Zone. And then you'd have to be like, Daddy, and hope to dear God that somebody manages to go into that corner of the shower and hears you and somehow saves you. So like, here's the shower quarter, and I'd be like, backed up against the side, and be like, please somebody either find me or give up now. I'd be terrified. All right. This one was fun, and this really only applied when I lived in a two-story house when I was a kid, when I was, like, maybe 5. If you sit down, and you cross your legs, and you cross your fingers, and you close your eyes, and you think really, really hard, like you start clenching everything until you start shaking, you could levitate. That's... Yep. And I think the way that I got this idea was once I was up at the top of the stairs and I crossed my fingers and my legs and did the closing the eyes thing and I found myself at the bottom of the stairs. I'm pretty sure someone carried me, but my little mind did not compute and thought that I floated down the stairs, and that was a thing. Number 5, 16 years old was the ultimate like age of awesome. And once you've hit 16, everything just plateaus and it's just not super awesome anymore. Because when you're 18, then you have to, like, be an adult. When you're 21, you have more responsibilities. Like, no. 16 was the bomb. And my logic behind this was you were capable of driving. You were apparently very pretty. You wore braces. Because to me, that equals pretty. I mean, it is. Some people really pull it off, but I couldn't pull off braces. And you would be in high school at that point. And you would be allowed to have a boyfriend. Those are the reasons I wrote. Number 6. This is a la Toy Story. All of my dolls, my stuffed animals, my everything would come to life when I was not around. And if I was mean to them, or I threw them, or was abusive towards them in any way, they'd become despondent and not like me anymore. And I would have to apologize in order for them to be my friend again. Yeah. And fun story about that. One of the reasons why I don't like the sound of the heartbeat, and I know it's irrational now, but like, whatever. I think I was 7 or 8, and I had one of those My Twin dolls. You know what those are, right? Where you go online and you show, like, a picture this way, and then a profile, and a profile, and then they make a doll that looks like you. Now, they're not as good as they are, as they used to be. They used to be way, way more customizable, and for some reason, they just aren't. They aren't as good. And they're also much smaller now than they used to be. But anyway, I had this doll, and it was an Amanda doll, because that's my name is Amanda. And, one day, my friend Edward and I were playing house, and I knocked her off the cat post somehow. Like, I didn't set her up right or whatever, and so she fell, and I was like, bad Amanda, bad Amanda, don't fall off the cat post, you could really hurt yourself, meh, meh, meh. And so I put her in timeout in my bathroom, and what you should know about my bathroom is that there are no ways to get into it besides through my room. The little window vent thing was way too high for anybody to get up to, and it was also about that big, so nobody could get through it. We put the doll in there, and we took the sound machine that my dad had given me, and I, like, pressed a bunch of buttons, and one of the sounds that came on was a heartbeat, but we were like, ugh, so we changed it. And then we were like, oh, crap, she's supposed to be in timeout, so we left the bathroom for 20 seconds to equal 20 minutes. And we came back, and, like, her hands were upside down, and her feet were different positions, and, like, her head was cocked sideways, and we were like, oh, what? And so we punished her again because she moved. That was our logic. And so we, like, reshifted her to be like this or something. And I came back and, like, both of her arms were down and her foot was upside down again and her head was cocked to a different side. And it was really, really creepy. And I was like, oh my god, my dog is coming alive. And so we brought it out into my room and we were like, oh my gosh, what would happen? What would make this do? And the last thing that we remembered doing right before was playing with the sound machine. And the last sound we played in the bathroom was the heartbeat. So we played it again and I was like, I'm so sorry, Amanda. You're a great daughter. I'm just going to put you in this in the bathroom again, but you're not in trouble this time, we're preparing a surprise. And so we put her in there, and we counted for 10 seconds that time, and she didn't move. And we decided that she had been possessed by the heartbeat in the sound machine. Yeah. And because I was mean to her, she disobeyed me. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see, next. Number 7. God had a small camera installed in every room and in the trees outside, so he could see you on one of those massive security camera screen things you see in movies and stuff. That's how he sees you. But they weren't in bathrooms, because that would be rude. Yep. Alright, number 8. I'm almost done. My mother had magic hands. Once, when I was like 4, we're living in San Antonio, I stepped in an ant pile, and there were ants just all up my legs and all over me. It was really scary. And I was like, Ma! My mom came out, and she like swiped down my leg, and they were just gone. They weren't on the concrete, and they weren't like anywhere. They just disappeared. My mom has magic hands. Number 9, if you cut the sandwich into triangles instead of squares, the sandwich will taste better. I don't have a story about that one. Oh, and 10, Barney was real. This is actually a fairly common one for stall children. But, I mean, I wasn't stupid. I saw the zippers and, like, the mask thing and the, like, where the gloves and the shoes, like, cut off and stuff. So I assumed that was protective gear that he put over his hands and feet and over his head so he wouldn't get sick from all of the kids that he worked with, because kids bring in germs. But they looked just like his head. In fact, they were just like clear and you were just seeing the outlines of these things. At least I kind of had logic, right? Yeah? But no. No, for some reason my brain still thought the zipper, like, wasn't a thing to question. Anyway, those are 10 things I believed when I was a kid. What are yours?
Okay, I love you, bye-bye.